have the normal activities going on. On Wednesday night, Bible study, or lunch and learn Bible study. We have an men's Bible study on Monday. It's great to see everybody today, and let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Gracious and compassionate God, we come before you today with open hearts and open minds, ready to receive all that you have for us. We ask your blessing and protection as we begin this worship service, and we pray that your presence will be felt in this place, and that we will be transformed by your everlasting love. In your Son's name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, I'm Sue Pearson, your liturgist. Please join with me with the call of worship. Welcome to God's house, a place of faith.
From our homes we come seeking God's word.
Here you will find nourishment and hope. May we learn the lessons of courage and peace. Here you will find rest from your struggles.
Lord, prepare our hearts to receive your words, that we may leave this holy house of faith and return to our homes, encouraged and challenged to be your Lord people. Amen. Love, people grew and flourished.
We want to see your presence in the world, but we spend far too much time looking for the big picture, rather than seeing the myriad of ways in which your love and healing power is shortened and shown. Forgive us when we grow impatient with you and with the course of things in our lives. Heal our wounds and put us back on pathways of peace and service. Enable us to speak your words of hope in this darkened world. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. The scripture for today comes from the book of Matthew, chapter 21, verses 33 to 43. Listen to another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a fence around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a watchtower. Then he leased it to tenants and went to another country. When the harvest time had come, he sent his slaves to the tenants to collect his produce. But the tenants seized his slaves and beat one, killed another, and stoned another. Again, he sent other slaves, more than the first, and they treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, saying, "They will respect my son." But when the tenants saw the son, they said to themselves, "This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and get his inheritance." So they seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and killed him. Now, when the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those tenants? They said to him, "He will put those wretches to a miserable death and lease the vineyard to other tenants who will give him the produce at harvest time." Jesus said to them, "Have you never read in the scriptures? The stone that the builders reject has become the cornerstone. This was the Lord's doing, and it is amazing in our eyes. Therefore, I tell you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that produces the fruits of the kingdom."
Thank you.
instill in us the mind of Christ. Bind us together in joy and affection, that we may look not only to our own welfare, but also to the welfare of others. Father, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of each of our hearts be acceptable to you. In your name, amen. Expectations. There's always expectations in life. So have you ever had trouble trying to get someone to understand what you were talking about? Parents and children are famous for having this problem. Parents don't relate to what their children are trying to tell them. And children don't relate to what the parents are trying to tell them. Spouses are notorious for lack of communication also. It isn't because they don't try to get through to the other person, and it isn't that they don't love each other. Quite often they talk more than the other person wants, but they just don't get through. We have trouble as humans explaining our expectations to others. Now, it's quite evident that we are made in the image of God, because God has trouble trying to communicate with people too. He gives us his written word, and we have pastors to explain the meaning to us. Pastors even have trouble trying to get someone to listen to what they're saying to. Hearing and listening are not the same. I can hear a lot of things, but that doesn't mean I'm listening. We humans can be a little stubborn sometimes, don't you think? Jesus had problems getting through to people when he was walking this earth. One of his favorite methods of communication was telling parables, a story. And that's what we heard today from Matthew. A landowner planted a vineyard, a beautiful vineyard. It was huge and completely fenced in, so the wild animals and everything couldn't get to it. And he had a big watchtower. The owner of the vineyard decided to lease the vineyard to some tenants and left it in their care. All he asked, his only expectation was, in return, they were to share of the produce, and the tenants gladly agreed. So asking for a share is quite different from making monthly payments. If you're making monthly payments to the bank or paying rent, the amount is the same every month. How much money you made that month doesn't matter. No matter if you have a big check or a small one, you still have to make the same payment. Now God asks for a portion, a part of what we make, be it large or be it small. This method is much fairer than the worldly way. When harvest time came, the landowner sent servants out to the vineyard to collect his share of the produce. High in the watchtower, the tenants saw the servants approaching. Instead of gladly welcoming them and giving them the rightful payment, the tenants beat up one of the servants, killed another, and stoned yet another. When word reached the landowner of what had happened, he was extremely displeased. He sent some more servants for his expected share, and the same thing happened again. So finally, the landowner decided to send his son. The farmers carried out their evil plan and killed the landowner's son. Now, all of Jesus' parables are filled with symbolism. In this one particular parable, my Life Application Study Bible describes it this way. The landowner is God. The vineyard, Israel. The tenants, Jewish religious leaders. The landowner's servants are the prophets and the priests who remain faithful to God and preach to Israel. The son, Jesus. The other tenants are the Gentiles. Israel disobeys God, rejects God's prophets, and even kills them. And finally, does away with God's own son. Verses 40 through 41 says, now when the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those tenants? And they said to him, he will put those wretches to a miserable death and lease the vineyard to other tenants who will give him the produce at the harvest time. Consequently, the promise is taken away from Israel and given to the new Israel, the Christian church. We're off the hook, eh? For a change, Jesus is talking to someone else besides us. We wish. He is talking to us too. A little further down in verse 43, he says, the kingdom of God will be taken away and given to people that produce the fruits of his kingdom. That is you and me. My friends, it is the Christian church, the church that Christ established. The word fruits, in the manner Christ used it, had the same meaning in Matthew's day as it does in ours. The kingdom that we want to be a part of is for fruit bearers. It is for those who seek to live lives of faithfulness to God's call in Jesus Christ. These are the people who follow the Christ and make him apparent, not only in words, but in deeds and actions. We have the responsibility of bearing the fruits of righteousness, repentance, and most importantly, the fruits of the Spirit. The Holy Spirit develops within Christians the fruit of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. If you want to look it up, it's found in Galatians 5, verses 22 to 23. The Christian church is a model to the world. The world looks to us, and if we aren't bearing the fruits of the world, we should be. The community we live in laughs at us and at God. Bearing fruit is about walking the walk as much as talking the talk. The Wednesday night Bible study group is studying the book of Job, and it's by Francis Chan. So at the end of chapter 1, he challenged us to remember daily that we aren't alone. He started session 2 with the following words. Last week, we talked about how we aren't alone. We're being watched right now. How did that affect your week, knowing that you were being watched the entire week? And that's being consciously watched. There's a bigger story going on. Did it change your actions? That practicing of the presence of God, knowing that he's aware of your thoughts and your actions and your words. These questions still keep me thinking and asking myself, am I along with bearing good fruit, we need to remember that we are temporary tenants in today's vineyard. Everything we have is on loan to us from God. We don't own anything, though we sometimes act as if we own it all. Up front, we have to realize everything belongs to God, our Creator. Do we as individuals and as the Christian church meet God's expectations for bearing fruit? Are God's words only for other people to do? Or do we act as if they apply to us? God is perfectly able to share his blessings with whomever he chooses. He can also remove those blessings, as he did with Job. That is something many people don't want to recognize. He did it to Israel, and he can do it to us, the new Israel. The promise of God is given to the church. It is a promise that we are to model to one and to all. What God wants and expects for all creations. God is merciful and God is gracious. He is slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. But that does not mean we can sit back on our laurels and do nothing. As the new Israel, the Christian church, the people of God, God expects our best. He expects our best. God loves you, and so do I. Amen. This next song is Sanctuary. It's in the faith we sing. You can follow along on the screen. But please listen to the words as we sing it. Thank you.
Going to Mayo this week as for Anne Marie, Brian, Bruce, and Tracy, ongoing health problems. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Concern for Dorothy Kuhn for Chris Colleton, continue healing from brain surgery. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Concern from Emily Miller for Nolan, who has a concussion and hoping for great healing. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Concern from Jenny Quayle, family of Bugs Bergman, who passed away on Thursday. Lord, in your mercy.
A lot of concerns this morning. I would like to ask Pastor Bob, because he will be traveling back. I don't know if it's today or tomorrow, but he will be coming back in town. And also, let's have a joke. The beautiful colors, even though it's raining, there's beautiful autumn colors out there. God's paintbrush is truly at work. And the sunsets that we've been having and the rising of the sun, they've been gorgeous too, because I guarantee you I've been up early enough to see them. So just a little piece of joy this morning. Please bow your heads. Loving God, we come this day to worship with so many things on our hearts and minds. We are drawn away by our problems and problems of our friends and cares for everybody. You know that we want to do, all we want to do is to serve you. And yet when things get tough, we have a tendency to buckle and cave in. Sometimes we lack the courage and strength to work for you. And you have reminded us that you will be continually with us. And we need to place our trust in that fact and none other. Your love, oh Father, your love will sustain us and heal us. Your mercy and your grace will give us courage and strength, joy and peace. Father, heal our spirits. Open our hearts. Help us. Help us to be your disciples. Lord, we surrender our prayer requests of joys and concerns into your capable hands. But Father, we also lift up any unspoken prayers that lay on our hearts, that something that we keep just between us and you. We remember those who are not with us this morning and ask that you watch over them. Help us to remember that you constantly lift and carry us in times of trouble, in times of stress. Bring us to the knowledge of your mercy and powerful love that will never, ever leave us. Father, prepare us. Prepare us for the ministry in areas of need and desolation. Father, help us to hear when you call, to step out of the box, to serve you. In the precious name of your Son, who taught us to pray, our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven, give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. It is invite you to come forward to place the tithes in the offering place up front. I believe there's also still one by the back door.
Thank you.
today as a people who bear the fruit of the kingdom, that in living a life patterned after God's grace, you may share the hope, joy, and love you receive from God with your neighbors wherever you go. Go in peace and serve the Lord.